was the topic?
Limestone and limestone manufacture. That's the topic.
Okay. So basically, tell me, what do you know about lime? What it is? What is lime and what is limestone? What is the basic difference between these two?
Lime is in lime's formula. Calcium oxide and limestone is calcium carbonate.
Exactly. Very good. Okay. So the preparation of this lime, calcium oxide, can be done in different processes. So the basic process in the production of lime will be taking from the limestone. So first one is quarrying. First, they will be obtaining it from the raw material. So the raw material used to extract lime is limestone.
Yeah.
Next step is they will be preparing this limestone for the further process. So the first preparation method will be starting by crushing and sizing it. Like they will be crushing it and making it into fine pieces.
Yes. Okay.
The third process is calcination. So what is called as calcination?
Not sure.
Okay. So in the next third step is calcination. In calcination, this calcium carbonate will be converted into calcium oxide.
Okay. Is it because when turmeric dissociates?
Yeah.
Okay.
First step is quarrying, extracting the raw material. Second step is crushing it into fine pieces. Third step is calcination. Calcination is just conversion of this calcium carbonate into calcium oxide. Exactly, it is a decomposition process. And the fourth step is hydrating the obtained product.
Hydrate, okay.
Yeah. So these are the four main steps that will be involved in the process of conversion of calcium carbonate into calcium oxide. So in quarrying or mining, so the raw material used for this is limestone. Where do we get this limestone?
Limestone can be found in chalk.
Yeah. And marble. How do we get them? We get them underground.
Yeah.
So this raw material, limestone, is extracted carefully to maintain its purity in underground mines and quarries all over the world. So these carefully extracted limestone will be next taken to the crusher, where it is crushed and screened to further wash so that they can remove all the impurities apart from the limestone, because apart from calcium carbonate, it will have other components as impurities. Some dust, mud, everything will be present. Since it is taking, we are extracting it from underground, it will be containing lot of impurities. So they will be crushing it into fine pieces and they will be including further wash so that you can remove all the impurities.
Okay.
So the next step is and foremost important step among all the steps. It is lime calcination. That is conversion of limestone, calcium carbonate to calcium oxide. CaCO3 will be converted into CaO. That is our calcination step.
Yes.
So this limestone, which is a source of calcium carbonate, is heated to convert the calcium carbonate into calcium oxide. So as we have learned the rules of dissociation.
Yeah.
We have learned in our previous lesson, isn't it?
Yes.
Like, depending upon the reactivity series of the elements, their carbonates will be dissociating. For highly reactive metals, it will be forming a different pattern. For least reactive, it will be forming a different pattern. And for moderately reacting elements, it will be decomposing in another pattern. So what about calcium? Is it highly reactive or moderate?
Moderately.
So this calcium carbonate, it will split into, in presence of high temperature, it will be splitting into calcium oxide and carbon dioxide will be released.
Yes.
So it is needed a very high temperature to make this calcium carbonate to undergo decomposition. So this entire reaction will be taking place in an furnace.
In a furnace, so it has to be very high temperature.
Exactly.
Okay.
So this this entire process of decomposition of calcium carbonate will generally be carried out in a large rotary kilns or a vertical shaft.
A
vertical shaft. You can rotate the kiln as well. So it is a rotary kiln or a shaft which will have a very, very high temperature inside it. You will have a fireplace inside it which will be having very high temperature.
Okay.
So a quick lime will be produced at the end of this calcination process.
Yes.
So at the end of this process, you will get quick lime. So this quick lime will be undergone to further process. It will be crushed or it will be directly used depending upon the usage. Depending upon the need, this quick lime will be taken to further processes.
Yeah.
The fourth step in the extraction of calcium oxide is hydration. So in this step, hydration is a process nothing but addition of water, isn't it?
Yes.
So the quick lime obtained here will be hydrated. As the result, you will get a product called slaked lime.
Slaked lime, okay.
Yeah. So quick lime is nothing but calcium oxide, isn't it? So yes. Calcium oxide will combine with water to form calcium hydroxide.
Yes.
Which you will be calling as slaked lime.
Okay.
So this limestone, which is CaCO3, is first heated. So it is converted into quick lime, whose formula is CaO. When you add water, that is hydration will be taking place, it will be converted into slaked lime, whose formula is CaOH twice.
Yes.
And when you carbonate the slaked lime, it will be further converted into calcium carbonate.
Okay.
Okay. So in this reaction, you are adding heat to the reactant, isn't it?
Yes.
So is this an exothermic or endothermic?
This is an exothermic.
Think again and tell.
Heat is added, sorry, endothermic.
Exactly. So when heat enters the system, then it is called as endothermic. And when heat exits the system, then it is called as exothermic. Okay. So here you could see that heat is entering into the reactor side. So when you write heat at the product side, that means heat is leaving the system. So here you are adding heat to the calcium carbonate to decompose it. So this is an endothermic reaction. So you need to produce lot of, so when this is done industrially, it is mandatory to extract large quantity of calcium oxide from the available reactant, isn't it? So the best thing that you can do is, you can apply Lee-Chatelier principle to the above.
Yeah.
So what is Lee-Chatelier principle?
Lee-Chatelier principle is Isn't it when
and this is an equilibrium reaction.
Like equal.
Yeah. So when you offer a stress or disturbance to an equilibrium reaction, the reaction will shift in the direction to nullify the effect of stress or disturbance that we have caused externally.
Yes.
So here, and the stress or disturbance that you can cause are increasing or decreasing the concentration of reactants or products.
Yes.
And next is, when you have gas molecules in this reactant, you can vary pressure.
Okay.
Reactants or products in any one side of the equation. If the system is dealing with gases, then you can include pressure also. You can cause a disturbance,
yes,
by using a pressure also.
Yes.
The third thing is temperature.
Temperature, okay.
Yeah. So let us see one after the other how they are applied to this above reaction.
Okay.
Okay. So according to Lee-Chatelier principle, when you increase the concentration of the reactant, the equilibrium will shift towards the production of,
yeah,
more product. So one thing you can do is you can increase the concentration of reactant, but the best method is from the available reactant,
yes,
you have to extract more product, isn't it? So instead, if you decrease the concentration,
yeah,
of more product will be produced from the available reactant. So the equilibrium will shift its position towards the production of product. Because you have removed the concentration,
yes,
of product, so the equilibrium will shift towards producing more product. That is the first method. So you have increased,
yes,
the yield. Increase the yield by decreasing,
yeah,
the concentration of the product. So in this equilibrium reaction, gases, isn't it?
Yeah.
So according to Lee-Chatelier principle, when you increase pressure, the equilibrium will shift its position in a side in which you could produce least,
yes,
number. So if in this equation, if you increase temperature, the reaction will move away from the gas molecule. So more reverse reaction will be more preferable. So instead,
yes,
you have to increase the pressure of this system, then more gas molecules will be produced to increase the lost pressure.
Increase a lot. Okay.
Yeah, so here in this product side only you have gas molecules. In reactant side, you have no gas molecules. So obviously, when you decrease pressure, more product will be produced so that more carbon dioxide can be released.
Okay.
So again, you are increasing the yield by decreasing the pressure.
Okay.
Next, temperature. So when you deal with temperature, the increase or decrease in temperature to get more yield will depend upon the whether the reaction is exothermic or endothermic.
Okay.
For an equilibrium reaction, when you,
yes,
add temperature to the system, when you increase the temperature of an equilibrium reaction, the reaction will proceed in the direction away from the heat term. Could you see I have written heat in the reactant side?
Yes.
Since this is an endothermic reaction, I have written heat in the reactant side. So obviously for this reaction, if I increase the temperature,
yeah,
more preferentially away from the heat term, so forward reaction will be taking place.
Okay.
So if for this endothermic reaction, if you decrease temperature, reverse reaction will be preferential.
Okay.
So according to Lee-Chatelier principle, you can decrease the concentration of the product, you can decrease the pressure of the system, and also you can increase the temperature of the system so that you can get more yield. So more calcium oxide can be extracted from the available reactant.
Yes.